Here we go, Ron. And we've talked about it. This is an IPW heavyweight title match. There you see him, former ECW star Julio De Niro, strutting his way into the ring, chasing Shannon Rose around, who never knows what's going on. And that'll get you some face heat, pushing Shannon Rose around right there. And here comes our champion, Ron Nene. He's been champion for a few months now. He beat AJ Styles for that title. He's Billy Fives.
Billy Fives, the IPW heavyweight champion, who has no respect for the Florida Wrestleplex, for the IPW hardcore wrestling fans, or for that belt itself. Tomorrow night at the May Massacre at the Florida Wrestleplex, Billy Fives was signed to defend his IPW heavyweight championship against Agent Steel, the winner of this year's Rage in the Cage. Billy Fives has refused to defend the title against Agent Steel. He will not be at the Wrestleplex. He says he's got better things to do. Agent Steel will face perhaps Scoot Andrews, maybe Mike Sullivan. Basically, Agent Steel is going to be in the number one contenders match because Agent Steel has to prove himself to Billy Fives, according to our champion. Billy Fives, I'll give him more credit where credit's due. He tries to take it to Julio De Niro with a nice little arm drag, and he gets it reversed, and now he's got an arm bar locked on. Billy Fives ain't quite the... He thinks... I don't... This guy gets me so...
All right, Ron, just calm down, calm down. I tell you what, I would think that the owners of IPW might have been a little bit more fair to Agent Steel. He won Rage in the Cage 4. He should get a title shot. He shouldn't have to be in a number one contenders match, but however you want to do things around here, Ron, Amy, everybody knows you don't listen to me anyways.
Nobody listens to you, Aaron. I was in glee. I was in ecstasy. I was basically enjoying this program without you sitting next to me, because I could call it like it is without being interrupted once and for all. But Billy Fives, I'm not stupid. Sure, he holds the upper hand because he is the rightful owner of the IPW Heavyweight Championship. He might be ducking this title shot by Agent Steel, but the truth of the matter is, we're not going to strip the belt off of Billy Fives. We're not going to suspend him, because that's what he's looking for. He wants to go out and say he's never lost his title. We're going to get the contract signed. We're going to have our lawyers at the same table as his. He will defend the belt against the winner of Agent Steel and whoever his mystery opponent will be tomorrow night at the Wrestleplex.
All right, nice shoulder tackle there by Billy Fives. Sorry to interrupt you there, Ron.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
But then again, if I didn't, people wouldn't know I was back. Sorry I'm not here with you trying to sell a kidney on eBay. I'm actually trying to call an IPW match the way it should be without kowtowing to you and saying absolutely about 100 freaking times.
Well, taking shots at Bobby Rogers, the owner of FOW, while he's not here. I'm going to leave that. I'm not going to tell. Look at that huge, huge suplex. This match has been very physical. When you look at Julio De Niro, a lot of people, they like to talk about him like he's some type of pretty boy. They like to talk about him. You see the fans are behind Billy Fights. I don't know what to say about that, except for maybe it's the cocky attitude of Julio De Niro. Maybe it's the fact he used to be in ECW, and he's perceived as some big independent superstar. Billy Fives, we might not like him, but look at the wicked kicks. Julio De Niro, if he hadn't worked on his midsection the way he does, somewhat like myself, Aaron, he wouldn't be able
somewhat
to kick those kicks. You've seen my ab.
Yes, I have, Ron, your big pony keg that you carry around, that you call a stomach there. But that's just all part of your gimmick, I suppose. And they're part of this match right now. Billy Fives just has his head ran into the second turnbuckle. I've never seen that maneuver before. And a nice little spin kick, almost Sweet Chin Music style, right to the bottom of the face of Billy Fives. And our champion is hurting, Ron Nene. And I tell you what, you talk about the fans being behind him. They may not like Billy Fives, but one thing our fans have proven, if you're going to wrestle an outsider, if you're going to be an outsider coming in here to IPW, you better be ready to contend with both your opponent and our fans, because they support our wrestlers 110%.
Julio De Niro is the type of guy, I might not like him all that much, but the truth is, look at that wicked leg drop off the top rope, and he clotheslines Billy right across the second. But again, the veteran should know better than this. Drag your opponent to the center of the ring, hook the leg, cover him for the pin, and you are the new IPW champion. Instead, he lets his head get the better of him. He doesn't hook the leg, and Billy Fives gets his leg on the ropes to break the pinfall attempt.
Yeah, I don't even think he actually got his leg there. I think it just landed there, just like he just landed right on the canvas from that wicked neck breaker, and we nearly had a new champion there, Ron. Only a two count by Mustachio Star Stevens.
Mustachio Star Stevens, the mud baby. Everybody loves this guy because he does everything he can to call it right down the middle when he's not being blown up.
Nice roll up there by Julio De Niro. Once again, nearly a new IPW champion. This is about the closest I've seen Billy Fives to having his title taken since he won it here on TV just a few months ago.
Again, I have to reiterate, tomorrow night at the May Massacre at the Florida Wrestleplex, Agent Steel will not be facing Billy Fives, the man who's ducking him for the so-called, he wants to be the so-called undisputed. He's doing what's got to be done. You're going to see Justice in Livewire tomorrow night. You are going to see Axis and Kubiak. You're going to see the IPW TV title match with Dr. Heresy against Pat McGroin. And right now,
once again, we almost had a pinfall there.
He don't seem like he's into it to me, Aaron. Is it me? Is it some type of perception problem that the 26-year-old Star Stevens is maybe a little bit out of it?
I don't know, Ron. It seems to me like maybe his ambition has been a little killed. I don't know what in the world Star Stevens could possibly do that might kill his ambition.
I have no guesses.
Oh, crotch shot.
Huge nut shot by Billy Fives. I kicked him in the ass, ref. I didn't kick him right in the McGroin.
Actually, what he was saying was, right now, Ron Nemi's calling commentary, and he's looking right at my bottom.
Julio De Niro was so complimentary when it came to the WrestleFlex. He put over the talent, he put over the building, but there's nothing he put over like Extra Innings Ballpark Cafe down on Central Avenue in St. Pete, because he enjoyed the hot, spicy chicken.
All right, Ron, all right. We do it every week.
With the cheese. I'm not making this up, Aaron, but Billy Fies, while he's arguing with Star Stevens, just happens to have his leg right across the throat of Julio De Niro, choking the life out of him, and Star Stevens ain't even figured it out yet.
All right, Ron, we've been talking about the 18th and the big, big matches coming up there, but let's not forget, IPW returns to the east coast of Florida next Friday, May the 24th. That's 1 week away, fans. Be sure to check it out. Ron, what are some of the big, big matches we have in store for our fans on the east coast of Florida?
We're going to be at Pine Ridge High School in Deltona on the 24th. You're going to see Frankie Capone and Python go for the unified.
Oh,
oh my God, look at that wicked German suplex. Drops Billy Fies right onto his neck, and he still kicks out.
And then he kicks Julio De Niro right across the chops. And if he's not knocked out, he's a better man than you are, Ron Nemi.
You know, people talk about taking it to the mat and taking away a guy's aerial arsenal and taking away some of the weapons he has when he's on his feet or in the air. Billy Fies doesn't matter if he's laid on his back, on his belly, standing up or flying through. How in the hell did he end up getting that wicked kick into the face of Julio De Niro? And Billy take, come on.
Oh, look at him, come on.
Start laying at Star Stevens, he's very frail. Look at him.
The only person more frail than Star in the back room is Shannon Rose. Oh, I guess I take that back.
Beautiful. Some wicked. Oh, look at the Star Stevens front.
Look at that.
And he ducks under. And they, oh, my God, look at that wicked move. We might have a new champion. And if Star Stevens counts to three or counts both guys to 10 and gets up and does that strut again, I'm going to projectile vomit, and then I'm leaving.
All right, so we can only hope for my sake and commentary that Star Stevens throws up here in the next few seconds.
That was honestly, we've had Rasta Man dancing in IPW, we've had the hardcore giant Ron Nemi, and I've been known to cut a rug. No, we haven't had Skandar Akbar here, the world famous wrestling dancing champion, but Star Stevens and that strut, that took the cake.
I tell you what, that is one of the funnier things I've seen here in IPW, and that's saying quite a lot. And look at Julio De Niro coming back with his second, third, maybe even fourth win here. All kinds of aerial maneuvers on our champion, Billy Fies. And what is he going for here, Nemi?
I have it. That's the De Niro drop ball.
What?
The De Niro drop ball.
Well, whatever it was, it's good for another two count. There was about as many two counts in this match so far as there were in Steamboat Savage at WrestleMania 3, one of the all-time classics. And I tell you, for a match that you're going to see here in IPW, it doesn't get a whole lot better than Billy Fies and Julio De Niro. And there goes Julio outside the ring. And I tell you, Ron, this may be one of the better matches we've had on TV in our entire run here at IPW Weekly Recap.
I enjoy watching our wrestling program and calling the matches alongside Aaron Royal. It doesn't matter that you're completely incompetent. Come on, Star. Star Stevens has obviously got some bone to pick with Billy Fies, but I don't know that. I'm sitting here thinking he's not calling it down the middle and favoring Julio De Niro, but that sure looked like a three count to me. And Billy Fies hits a huge sit-out powerbomb. What the? Are these guys even beatable? They got a counter for every counter. They got a pin attempt for every other guy's pin attempt. At the 24th of May in Deltona at the Pine Ridge High School, this is the type of action you're going to see here in Royal.
And there we go. Star again. Oh!
Come on, Star.
One. Two. Oh, nearly a three count. The Billy rolls through it. Oh, one,
and he's got the tights.
And he's got the tights. What a champion.
It was right in the face of Star Stevens, who has been bending the rules totally against Billy Fies for the entire match. And now he rolls through his own roll-up. hooks the tights, pulls him halfway over his head, and starts Steven Zach's blood. What the hell is wrong with this guy?
Ron, you're going to drive yourself crazy trying to make sense of what Star Stevens does in the ring, but make no mistake about it. He is the senior official here in IPW, and make no mistake about it, still your champion of IPW, Billy Fives. Fans, we're going to be back with some clips of New Jack and Chaos in just a minute.